Forgive me, here's the president.
We'll take some pictures, okay?
Yes, sir.
Thank you all very much.
President, how about that Bombs Street?
Very, very proud of the people. Another, really another successful job. We're very, very proud of our military. Just like we're proud of the folks in this room, we are so proud of our military, and it was another successful event.
Did you authorize it, sir?
Everybody knows exactly what happened, so, and what I do is I authorize my military. We have the greatest military in the world, and they've done a job as usual. So we have given them total authorization, and that's what they're doing. And frankly, that's why they've been so successful lately. If you look at what's happened over the last 8 weeks and compare that really to what's happened over the last 8 years, you'll see there's a tremendous difference, So we have incredible leaders in the military, and we have incredible military, and we are very proud of them. And this was another very, very successful mission. Thank
Mr.
you very
President,
much.
Does it send a message to North Korea?
Thank you.
Does it send a message to North Korea?
I don't know if this sends a message. It doesn't make any difference if it does or not. North Korea is a problem. The problem will be taken care of. I will say this. I think China has really been working very hard. I have really gotten to like and respect, as you know, President Xi. He's a terrific person, spent a lot of time together in Florida, and he's a very special man. So we'll see how it goes. I think he's going to try very hard.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you
very much.
So important to note there, the president, you know, not in the same breath, two separate questions asked first about the bomb in Afghanistan and then the follow-up on North Korea. So to your point, it was almost like the question was asked, is this sending a message to North Korea? Even though the president sort of said, I don't know if this necessarily sends a message, you're saying, yes, it does.
Oh, it certainly has to, because they haven't used this weapon before. You know, they're used it on underground tunnels in Afghanistan.
That's exactly. It's never been used in battle ever. Never. It was developed during the Iraq War, but has never been used.
And so now that they have the target, they have not only ISIS in Afghanistan, but they also have, you know, North Korean tunnels where a large part of the North Korean military has hidden itself. And, you know, in 2003, during the Iraq War, Kim Jong-un, the ruler of North Korea, his dad, Kim Jong-il, spent 6 weeks underground. He was worried about George W. Bush. I think that this guy's worried about Donald J. Trump.
Do you think at all this was a test run?
They knew it was going to work, but I actually think that they timed it just because they wanted to sort of unnerve Kim Jong-un. And this is on before Saturday, where the 105th anniversary of Kim Il-sung's birth, the founder of North Korea, his grandfather, he's going to maybe demonstrate his power with the detonation of the country's sixth device, and that is going to unnerve us. I think Trump was trying to unnerve him first.
The back and forth between these two countries. What about his comments about President Xi of China, who he was meeting with last weekend at Mar-a-Lago when the U.S. decided to pull the trigger on those 60 or 59 Tomahawk missiles in Syria? And apparently his conversation with President Xi, you know, essentially saying, you help us with North Korea and we won't, you know, ask for as stringent of trade deals from you.
Yeah, I wouldn't make that particular deal because we need progress on both. But both of Trump's predecessors tried to work with China. We really tried to do that, especially since 2003, beginning of the six-party talks, where we put Beijing at the center of the world's efforts to disarm North Korea. It didn't work then. You know, Xi Jinping has been in power since November 2012. The North Koreans have detonated three nuclear devices. You know, he hasn't stopped those. China has some real interest in making sure North Korea unnerves us. They use it to destabilize the United States and our partners. I hope there was a change of heart in the last 2 days on the part of the Chinese leader, but we really got to see it before we believe it.
Gordon Chang, thank you so much.